29 नवंबर 2021 मॉर्निंग मुरली ओम शांति बप्तादा मधुपन स्वीट चिल्ड्रन यू मे नॉट बी अफ्रेड ऑफ एनीवन इन द वर्ल्ड बट यू शुड डेफिनेटली बी अफ्रेड ऑफ दिस फादर टू बी अफ्रेड ऑफ हिम मीन्स टू बी सेव्ड फ्रॉम परफॉर्मिंग सीनफुल एक्शंस क्वेश्चन Why does Baba give all your children Srimad to check your charts? Answer: Because God's laws are very strict. If after becoming a Brahmin you continue to make small mistakes, the punishment will be very severe. Therefore, Baba says, check yourselves. If any old karmic accounts remain, you will receive a small chapati, means reward. Together with the sleeper means punishment. The time of settlement is now very close. Therefore, settle all your karmic accounts with the power of yoga. Om Shanti. Your children stay in the remembrance of the father by yourselves. There is no need to tell you over and over again to do this. The father's directions is Remember the father while walking, sitting and moving around. You will then conquer Ravan who made you impure. You are not given any weapons etc. You conquer Ravan with just the power of yoga. You definitely have to gain victory which is attained at the confluence age when the kingdom of Ravan ends and the kingdom of Ram is to being established. The father can never teach you violence. The supreme religion of the deities is non-violence. The world doesn't know that the violence of the sword of lust doesn't exist there. Those who became viceless in the previous cycle will accept what you tell them. You are now on a battlefield. The Shiv Shakti army has been remembered. You are incognito warriors and each one of you is doing everything for yourself. Become conquerors of Maya and conquerors of the world. You are doing everything of yourselves, which means you are doing it for your land of Bharat. Those who make very good effort in this will receive something. Those who are victorious over the five vices will become conquerors of the world. You don't have to conquer anything else. You have to conquer the kingdom of Ravan. That is, you have to imbibe divine virtues. Unless you imbibe divine virtues, you cannot go to the golden age. So ask yourself, to what extent have you imbibed divine virtues? To imbibe divine virtues means to conquer Ravan. It is said there was the kingdom of Ram, but there can't have been just one Ram who ruled the kingdom. There must also have been the subjects. Here, the king, the queen, and the subjects are all conquering Ravan. They are imbibing divine virtues. Your food and drink, your way of speaking are all pure when you have divine virtues. Speak the truth about everything. The Father is the truth. So, you have to be so honest and truthful to such a father. If you are not truthful, your state becomes very bad. You have to reach an elevated state. You have to become Narayan from an ordinary man and Lakshmi from an ordinary woman. It is said, only you know your ways and means. You receive such a high status by following the directions of the father gives you. The highest on high father enables you to claim the highest state. Therefore, now follow Srimad and imbibe divine virtues. The sins of many births can't be cut away without the power of yoga. A very good pilgrimage of remembrance is needed for this. You will be able to have very good remembrance at Amrit Vela. The atmosphere is very good at that time. No matter how much you sit during the day, there is no other time like that of Amrit Vela. Everything of ours is incognito. In English, it is said, we are at war.
Our war is with Ravan. He is the number one enemy. The community of Ram conquered the community of Ravan by following Srimad. The Father is the almighty authority. The poor world is in complete darkness at this time. They don't know that they have been defeated. They have been defeated by Maya. No one even knows what Maya is. There was the kingdom of Ravan over the whole of Lanka. They have written so many tall stories of the path of devotion and the scriptures. You have been reading those for birth after birth. Even now, they say that you should read the scriptures, that those who don't study them are called atheists. The Father says, by studying the scriptures, all of you have become atheists. Your children have to explain these things very well. When Bharat was Satupradhan, it was called heaven. Those same people of Bharat have become impure and Tamapradhan while taking 84 births. And so, how can they now become pure? The Father says, remember me and you will become Satupradhan and pure. Don't remember any bodily beings. Don't make anyone your guru. It is said, there is extreme darkness without a guru. There are so many gurus. However, all of them lead you into darkness. The Father says, when the sun of knowledge rises, extreme darkness is dispelled. Although sannyasis became pure, they still take birth through vice. Deities are not born through vice. Here, everyone's body is like impure. Dirty clothes. The Father washes such dirty, impure clothes. You have to make effort to make yourselves, the souls, pure so you also receive pure bodies. Check yourselves to see you do not perform any bad actions. God's laws are very strict. When someone does something bad, the punishment for that is very severe. It is the time of settlement. All karmic accounts have to be settled with the power of yoga. If you don't settle them, you will have to experience punishment. It is then said, punishment is received together with a small reward. Everyone is going to receive a small reward. Everyone will be given the reward of liberation and liberation in life. Some pass with honor, some will experience punishment and then receive a small reward with no honor. They will not be able to sit on the throne. If you perform bad actions, you will be dishonored. And that, in front of the Father too, Sri Baba is sitting here. You will be given visions. I was in Dasvan and explained to you so much. I am now in the perfect Brahma. Your children go to the perfect Baba. Sri Baba gives you the directions through him. Baba will give you visions of how he used to sit in Dasvan and teach you and tell you. Imbibe divine virtues and do service. Don't defame anyone. You still did that and so this is the punishment for it. There will have to be punishment for whatever sins you have committed. Some experience a lot of punishment and others less. That too is number wise. As much as possible, continue to cut your sins away with the power of yoga. The greatest concern your children should have is how to become completely real gold. While walking and moving around, it should remain in your intellect that you will claim a high status according to how much you stay in remembrance. You mustn't be concerned about the storms of Maya. Remember the Father whenever you have time. I have to become Satupradhan from Tamapradhan. If you remember the Father, your sins will be cut away. You mustn't commit any sin. Otherwise, they will accumulate 100-fold. If you don't ask for forgiveness, they will increase and eventually everything will be ruined. Maya will make you commit sin after sin. There would then be disrespect for the unlimited Father. Many are unaware of this. Baba always explains, always consider it to be Shubaba speaking the Murli and Shiv Baba, giving directions so that you remember him and are also afraid of him. Many continue to commit sin. You should tell Baba clearly, "Baba, I made this mistake." The father explains, "There is a huge burden of sin on your heads. Tell Baba about everything you have done. Half will be reduced by telling Baba the truth." Baba has explained that the one who becomes the number one charitable soul then becomes the number one sinful soul. Baba himself says, "This is the last of your many births. You were charitable souls. You have now become sinful souls and you once again have to become charitable souls. You have to benefit yourselves. There is no need for you to bow down here. Simply remember the father. Although this one is old, he still says namaste. Children do not repeatedly say namaste while at home. When one person says namaste, the other one responds once. Baba says, you say namaste to me, considering me to be senior, and I say namaste to you, considering you to be the masters of the world. This is full of meaning. People say Ram, Ram, but they don't understand the meaning of that. In fact, Ram means Shri Baba. Ram is not the one from the highest clan of Raghu, but incorporeal Ram, and his name is Shri Baba. No one would say in front of Shiv that he is worshipping Ram. The father now says, go and explain at the temples. He too was a human being. You go and sing praise in front of them. You are viceless and full of all virtues, whereas I am a degraded sinner. These are human bodies, means now. And those two are human bodies, means Dides. But those bodies have divine virtues and so they are Dides. You yourself say you have devilish traits and so you are like monkeys. The features of the two are similar, but the characters are different. The people of Bharat were crowned. Now they have no crowns. The people of Bharat are now poor. The father comes in Bharat. The father comes in the place where heaven is to be created. It is said, Kalangi Avatar, the incarnation that has been defamed so much. If those of other religions say something, they are only following the people of Bharat. Because they are those with stone intellects, they also say that he is in the pebbles and stones. They don't know the father at all, and they don't know he enters this one and makes Bharat crowned, means the highest. He serves Bharat so much. The father says, you defame me and I make you into the masters of the world. You defame me so much. Ravan has completely destroyed your common sense. You have reached a very bad state, and this is why you call out to the purifier. The explanation you are given is so easy, and yet many of your children forget this. If you don't have yoga, you are unable to imbibe this. This is why Baba says those in bondages remember the father the most. They also tolerate a lot in remembrance of Shri Baba. Only the people of Bharat who are to become deities will come here. The Arya Samajis do not believe in the idols of the deities at all. At the top of the tree, there are branches and twigs of those who hardly take two or three births. Many people wonder how the world would continue without vice. Oh, but the deities are said to be completely viceless. No one understands that vice doesn't exist there. Those of the previous cycle will understand this very quickly. It is remembered that God says lust is the greatest enemy, but no one knows when God said this. Your children are now becoming the conquerors of the world, but effort has to be made to claim a high status. The father says, while living at home, simply connect your intellects in yoga to me. Now that you belong to the Father, you should have love for the Father. Have love for others just and mean. Let your intellects be concerned about how to make the poor into residents of heaven and how to show them the way to go on the true pilgrimage. Those are physical pilgrimages that you have been going on for birth after birth. Thus is the only pilgrimage of remembrance. Our 84 births have now come to an end and the history of the golden age has to repeat again. Impure ones cannot go back home. The purifier father is needed to make you pure. Although sannyasis became pure, they cannot go back home. Only the father takes everyone back home. The father comes and liberates you all from Ravan and makes you free. There is nothing in the golden age that causes sorrow. The very name is the land of happiness. This is the land of sorrow. That is the ocean of milk, whereas this is the ocean of poison. You now know how they live in the heaven with so much happiness and comfort. No one knows how you come out of the ocean of milk and go into the ocean of poison. The father tells you to follow Srimad and that he is then responsible. Srimad says you may go and look after your children. Continue to buzz this knowledge to them so that they can be benefited a little and go to heaven. The father comes and changes you from residents of hell into residents of heaven. For 21 births, only you have this in your intellects. People don't know anything. This one didn't know anything previously either. Just as there is the story of this one's 84 births, so the same applies to you. He too is studying Raj Yoga. You are Raj Rishis and those people are Hatha Yogi Rishis. You are attaining a kingdom by living at home. All of you have come here to seek refuge. Those people believe they are sitting in heaven. There is the pomp of Maya in the world. How could heaven exist unless hell is destroyed? The people influenced by Maya consider this to be heaven. Baba has to make so much effort to establish the new world. All are complete residents of hell. They don't become residents of heaven at all. The father explains to you with so much love. Acha, sweetest children, you will become conquerors of the world by conquering Ravan. Full effort has to be made for that. Acha, to the sweetest, beloved, long lost and now found children, love, remembrance and good morning from the mother, the father, Babdada. The spiritual father says, Namaste to the spiritual children. The spiritual children says, Namaste and good morning to the spiritual father. Essence for the dharana. First point, don't perform any actions that would dishonor you and bring you punishment. Don't be concerned about the storms of Maya, but remember the father whenever you have time. Have true love for the one father. Second point, in order to reach an elevated state, remain honest and true to the true father. Don't hide anything. Blessing, may you use the mantra of remembrance to achieve imperishable success in your thoughts and actions and become an embodiment of success. Explanation. Your children are messengers of the Almighty Government. Therefore, do not allow your mind to be disturbed while discussing anything with anyone. Use the mantra of remembrance. When someone is not able to be controlled by the words or other methods, they use magical mantras. You have the eyes of soul consciousness vision and the mantra of Manmanabhav with which you can make your thoughts practical and become an embodiment of success. Slogan, instead of being action conscious, become soul conscious. Om Shanti.